I always wondered if there were others. You're probably thinking that lamp's just a tool to be used as you see fit. Take it lightly, and you'll find it's the other way around. Mark my words. I don't know who you are, and I don't care. But since it seems a deer has you marked, making you a bigger threat to the Rogar serves us both. I've defied the wills of gods and kings. If you know any kind of freedom, you'll do the same.
Fall back! Fall back! No! Wait! Where are you going? Help us!
You carry the lamp long enough, and you'll see history repeat, over and over. If you don't want to keep retreading the same ground yourself should you fall, make use of this. I've given you more umbral guidance than I ever had. From now on, find your own way and stay out of mine.
Oh, holy Aureus, by your radiance, grant me the strength to continue to endure these dark days, to lay bare the path to salvation for my wayward brothers and sisters, so we may walk it together and to strike down all those who would see our will defied. Even as our suffering continued, I honored my pledge of patience to the Exactor. And yet you now appear before me, a stranger, bearing what was not yours to receive. A betrayal made flesh, and one I cannot brook. Brothers and sisters, you honor us and all who came before you with your sacrifices. While I wish they were unnecessary, my wishes will not ease your suffering, but I pray my sorcery does.
Welcome, Dark Crusader. I had no doubt in my assessment of you, as one worthy of the monumental task which lies before us, Crusader. My name is Dunmire, and I am an exactor of the Dark Crusaders, the holy order of which you are now an honored member. The Church of Orion Radiance has assigned to me the duty of purging Mornstead of its Rogar blight, and ensuring the ancient tyrant Ethryg knows no liberation from his enduring imprisonment. While the schism between the Church and Judge Cleric is of long standing, she and her hallowed sentinels, now perverted, did at least construct Mornstead's radiant beacons, which have prevented Adir's return for centuries. But now, they stand corrupted and on the verge of collapse. It is to these five beacons you must turn your eye. Use the Umbral Lamp to cleanse them of Adir's destructive influence, and deliver salvation to a world on the brink of perdition. Rogar and Hallowed Sentinel alike will offer you no quarter, so remember, though Aureus' mercy is without limit, yours should not be. Rogar and Hallowed Sentinel alike will offer the Aureus' mercy is without limit. You serve a higher purpose, Crusader. To strive in darkness, in light we walk.
By Aureus' divine will, I live again. It's a miracle. And to think I raised my sword to you, when all along you were a divine instrument sent by him to deliver my death and rebirth and bring clarity. Forgive me, Lampbearer. I'm Pieta of the Hallowed Sentinels. And as Aureus sustains me, so too will I sustain you. Whether by making manifest your potential or through my healing blood, contained within the sanguinarix you carry. Should you find any saintly quintessences, bring them to me, and they can bolster the power of my blood further still. The beacons must be cleansed, the hallowed sentinels restored, and Adir's malignancy eradicated. Through whatever is to come, fellow chosen of Aureus, we stand together in service of him.
So the Exactus found himself a new instrument, as Exactus are wont to do. And given that lamp was intended for me, should his paladin fall. And yet now here you are, lamp bearer. Well, it seems I was right to doubt the value of a Dark Crusader's work. I'm Stomund, captain of the Fidelis. A group of good men and women who've made a stand against the madness which has possessed the rest of the hallowed sentinels. We made a vow to restore our order to its former glory, whatever the cost to ourselves. And by Judge Cleric's grace, we'll honor that vow. That heretical umbral lamp and the Dark Crusaders are necessary evils in these dire times, as are you, it would seem. Perhaps our aims will align further, or perhaps not. That heretical umbral, as are you, it would seem. Perhaps our aims will align further, or perhaps not.
Look at you, a Dark Crusader, a lamp bearer, and a revenant to boot. Aren't you the multifaceted one? Well, we Fidelis aren't as fortunate. We tend to stay dead when we die. And Aureus knows enough of us have done just that. Anyway, like Nathaniel says, you keep looking back, you don't see the blade coming at your front. We set ourselves a task and we have to finish it. Best watch your step out there. Mornstead is a land awash in blood, both deserved and undeserved alike. Best watch your step out there. Mornstead is a land.
That lamp you've got there is heresy, stranger. But then, seems it's getting harder to tell what is and what ain't nowadays. Ah, strange times. But in the end, there's right and there's wrong. And that never changes. And I hope for both our sakes you know the difference. But if in doubt, you heed the captain. He's never steered me wrong, much as he might think otherwise. But if in doubt, much as he might think otherwise.
The lamp must be born until the favored child makes themselves known. Only then can the remaining carrion of creation finally return to the void. The lamp must be born until the favored child. Only then can the
While the beacon should remain your most pressing task, I would have you perform another for me concurrently. Seek out and return to me the items which stand as proof of the Hallowed Sentinel's heretical deviations and practices. For only in the study of such can we hope to turn them towards the true light of Aureus. This land is overflowing with sin, so I expect this undertaking to offer you little difficulty. Also, say nothing of this to Pieta or the Fidelis Captain. They are already conflicted. Troubling them further only endangers them and our mission. You serve a higher purpose, Crusader. To strive in darkness, in light we walk.
That's it, isn't it? Oh, the Lamp of Immortality. And the genuine article. Not a useless, empty vessel like the one I saw that witless fool bumbling around with. I've learned a little since coming to Mornstead about that lamp and the awful mission to which it's attached. I hope you recognize that frightful burden for what it is. In truth, what's been done to you is downright cruel. Of course, some people are born into roles of tremendous responsibility. My name is Andreas of Ebb, esteemed scion of nobility, but far more than that, descendant of the great ruler Andanas himself, as proven by my family's book of lineage, for one. That's right. Through my veins flows the blood of the legendary hero who defied Adir and the Rogar and saved the whole world, only to be betrayed and murdered by a common criminal. So you'll understand a man of my pedigree cannot simply stand idle while an unfortunate victim such as yourself remains shackled to such a grim fate. Give me the lamp, and let me shoulder your burden, friend. What say you? No? It saddens me to see you bring such agony down upon your own head. I hope you see sense and reconsider. My offer stands as long as necessary. After all, what man of breeding would turn away from one so clearly in need? My offer stands as long as necessary. After all, what man of breeding would turn away from one so clearly in need?
Careful if you're headed for Pilgrim's Perch, friend. The hallowed sentinels don't welcome everyone. Not even a faithful pilgrim who's crossed countless miles of land and sea to join them. All I wanted was to serve the divine judge cleric, but they deemed me unworthy and chased me off. What's a poor, rejected disciple to do now, I ask you? I gave away most of what little I owned before I left Perdam. But if you've got some traveling of your own to do, then here, take this. I know it doesn't look like much, but it's been a dependable companion to me. It's a harsh wind that blows in Mornstead, but a tree that doesn't bend breaks, I suppose. It's a harsh wind that blows in Mornstead, but a tree that doesn't bend breaks.
most blessed representatives of the Holy Church Cleric. My soul soars to see...
Hold your tongue, pilgrim. And on your feet, you are on sacred ground. And we are yet to see whether you are deserving of that honor.
I assure you, I have dedicated my life to the teachings of Judge Cleric. My faith in her and her divine works is boundless.
Pray it is, for our Immaculate Lady's light will lay bare the truth. And in radiance, there is judgment.
The cleric's welcome comes behind the edge of a sentinel's blade, more often than not in this place. Makes me curious how you're still breathing. I suppose dangling the promise of salvation from one hand and the threat of death from the other keeps a pilgrim obedient. Ah, on second look, you're not just another deluded lamb, are you? You know, not long ago, I saw a dark crusader carrying that same lamp. Now it's in your hands. Again, curious. I know they'd see you rejuvenate those obscene monuments preventing a deer's return. Don't. That's a threat. But also advice. A deer rewards the faithful. There's salvation here if you want it. But you won't find it in the light of the sun or that lamp. there's salvation here if you want it. But you won't.
Another lamp-bearer. Aye. So it goes.
Should you end up one of the few to earn a vestige, I'll tend to it, as I do. For whatever it's worth. And until I'm in the ground myself. The Hallowed Sentinels and Rogar will both show you horror enough, but nothing like what that lamp brings into view. And remember, you look into the shadows. Might be the shadows look back. Mind yourself, Lamp-bearer. Whether you took up that light willingly or not, you're on a treacherous path. And forever's never as long as you think. Mind yourself, Lamp-bearer. You're on a treacherous path. And forever's never as long as you think.